If you're trying to take control of your payment processing and automate as much as possible, you are going to love this video. I'm going to be showing you how you can actually create an invoice in Stripe all through an automation that starts from SmartSuite. This allows you to keep all your data in one place, work from your central source of truth, but all the other things are going to be happening in the background automatically. If that's of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. Some of our favorite no-code tools are going to be showcased in this video. Specifically, I'm thinking about Make and SmartSuite. We love SmartSuite as a back-end database, and we absolutely love Make for those more complicated automated processes that you might want to build. And that's exactly what we're doing here in part two of this series, showing you how to create invoices automatically in Stripe from your SmartSuite source of truth. But before I get into it, I first want to invite you to join me for some training. Free automation training is going to help you understand the fundamental building blocks of automation so that you can automate more in the background and save more of your time. If that's of interest, grab that free training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. But without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen here. Feel free to follow along with me in your own SmartSuite, your own Make, your own Stripe. If you don't already have these accounts set up, please consider using our affiliate links wherever you found this video. That is going to allow you to get set up with some free pro trials, and you can just follow along right with me here. All right, well, as I already mentioned, we had part one in this already put together, where we started with two tables, contacts and organizations. And the key takeaway from part one is we learned how to build that customer object using an automation, and we did that inside of Stripe. So we brought that customer object back to us when we were all said and done, and now we have that information in our solution. Well, now, my friends, it's time to add that third table of invoices. And as you can see here, I've already built this out, but let me walk with you through these different steps so that you can build this as well. So the first part we need is a linked relationship to our contacts table. That's, of course, because when we create an invoice, we are going to be sending it to one contact only. Of course, it might be possible where you want to forward that invoice to multiple other people, but the way Stripe works is we're only creating one invoice for one customer. We need to relate to that object, that customer object. So you need to have a linked relationship here to only one. Make sure you've toggled off this multiple record link. Now, part two of this, we also need to know the customer object that we have in our contacts table. So to access this information, we can use a lookup field. When we build a lookup, it's basically saying, hey, I've got a linked relationship to another table, and I want to bring back specific information. In this case, I have a link to contacts, and I want to know what the Stripe ID is. If I look over at my contacts table, that's what we called this particular component here, where we brought back the customer object from Stripe. Well, I'm looking that up so that I have access to that information here in this table. Next, I'm listing out my service and my price. So I have a service right here. This is just a text field, and I have a currency field here where I'm dropping in the price. For our automation, I'm assuming you only have one service slash price that you're including on every invoice. If that's not the case, you're going to need some sort of looping mechanism here, where you've included multiple different services on the invoice, and you're gonna loop through the creation of that service multiple times. Again, we're not getting that complicated in this example, so it's just gonna be one thing that we're creating an invoice for every time. Now, I'm also including a field here for the invoice ID. This, again, is a text field that we set up inside of SmartSuite. And just as we did in part one, once we create that invoice in Stripe, we want to collect that invoice ID and bring it back into our system here in SmartSuite. That will allow us to do more advanced things with it in the future. If we know what the invoice ID is, then we can manipulate it with additional automation. For example, maybe when that thing gets paid, we want to come back here and update the status of the invoice as paid using an automation. Well, that's only going to be possible if we know what invoice to update, so let's make sure we bring back that ID. Now, we also want to have the record ID. And as we demonstrated in part one, we like using the formula here more than just using the record ID field type. So what I've done is I create a formula field type. I go to the advanced settings of that formula and I build this formula that just calls up the record ID. Now you can name this whatever you want. We're going to use this to map to our proper records. And then lastly, every invoice is going to need a due date, so we need that component as well. So once you've built these pieces inside of your SmartSuite, it's time to head on into the automation process itself. So what does that look like? Well, there's a lot more steps here than there were in our previous automation. Let's break them down one at a time. Now, the first part is always the trigger. This is the most complicated part of most automations. And as I mentioned in part one, I absolutely love using Mailhooks here. So when I set up a Mailhook, all I'm doing is I'm copying this Mailhook. It's an email address. I'm copying it to my clipboard and I'm going back into SmartSuite. And I'm building an automation in SmartSuite that meets certain conditions and sending to that Mailhook. In this example, I'm saying, look, I've got to have a price that's more than zero. I've got to have a customer Stripe ID, right? If I don't have this information, I can't create an invoice. I must have a contact linked to a record in my invoices table. I must have a service that I've outlined. And I cannot have an invoice ID. If I have an invoice ID, it means that we've already created an invoice inside of Stripe. I don't want to do it again. Now, one component that's missing here is going to be that due date. So let's find our due date for invoice and make sure that this is not empty. This is not empty. If it is empty, then I don't want to trigger this automation because I don't know when that particular invoice will be due. Okay, now, once I'm happy with these conditions, that's what's going to trigger the automation, and then all I'm doing is I'm sending information to that mail hook. That's what I copied from Make, drop it right here in your to address, and then all I'm doing is I'm bringing in the record ID that I created into the subject line. I must have a body in my message here, but it doesn't matter what I say. All I care about is the record ID. So do put, you know, whatever jargon you want in the message. We're never going to look at this. All I care about is the record ID. Once I'm happy with this, we save the automation. And most likely, I should also rename it so that I know which one it is. Now, we did these exact same steps when we created our customer object in Stripe. So this is just doing it again, this time for the invoice. Now, once I'm happy with this, that is going to trigger the automation. So that's sending the information out here to the mail hook. And when it gets picked up, we need to then search SmartSuite. What does that look like? All we're doing is we're saying, well, we're mapping to our solution. We're mapping to our invoices table now. And we are going to search that invoice record ID field for the subject. Because remember, inside of our mail hook, we passed along in the subject of our mail, we passed along the record ID. And so what we're doing is we're looking at this field back in SmartSuite. And because this is the record ID, we are finding a one-to-one match. All we're doing is we are locating this particular record inside of SmartSuite so that we can find out all the information about the invoice that we want to create. Now, once we have that done, we're going to create an invoice item. Now, this is the step that you might need to repeat in the case where you have multiple different things that you're adding to the same invoice. In that case, your automation is going to be a little bit more complicated than this one. Again, we're assuming that you just have the one thing that you're creating. So what's it look like? Well, part one is we know the customer Stripe ID from the previous step in our automation because we found that information. We called that customer Stripe ID. That is this field right here. Remember, we're looking up the customer object for Stripe, and we must include it here in our customer ID. Stripe is looking for that unique customer identification in order to create this invoice. Now, for us, we're creating this invoice by total amount. You have a few options, though. You can do it by a unit amount and a quantity. So it could be like, I have $10 each, and I've got 50 of them. And so then Stripe will do the math in the background. You can also do by an existing price object. But no, for us, keeping it simple, total amount. So I'm taking my price, but you have to understand that Stripe thinks about these prices in terms of cents. So I have to multiply this by 100. In order to get that little multiplication component, make sure you come up here to this little function symbol and bring in that operator. So I'm taking the price, which for us is 1,000, and in order to treat it like 1,000 cents, we have to multiply it by 100. If we don't, it's going to take 1,000, it's going to assume cents, and it's going to make it $10 for our invoice. It's not what we want. We need to multiply $1,000 by 100 to get the number of cents, and then it's going to work out just fine. Now for us, I'm doing this from the US, so my currency is USD. You have to bring in yours here. And next, we're going to go to the description of the line item that we're creating. For us, we pass that information in service. So here it is. If I look at service, I just called it example service for this one. And that is what's going to get plugged into the description of this line item that we're creating for this particular customer. So all we've done right now in this step is created a line item for the customer. We haven't created the invoice yet. That's the next step. So now we create the invoice, and what it's going to do is it's going to say every open line item that's been created for this customer, which for us is just the one that we just created, well, now I'm going to take that, stack it onto an invoice, and send it on out. So here we go. Connection to your Stripe account. Bring in your customer ID again. Now for us, because we have it in this module, we can just bring in the customer from that module. You can also use the customer object that we found in SmartSuite in this other step. It doesn't matter, it's all the same customer object. Now for us, we're going to send the invoice, but I want to point out that you can also charge automatically. If you have the payment information for your clients already on file, you can build that right here as well. Now over here, we're going to bring in either a day until due or a due date. For us, we passed a due date into our invoice table back here. We have the due date for the invoice. You might also just choose to bring in a number of days from now. So you might say, hey, every time I create an invoice, it's due a week from now or 2 weeks from now. So you can just plug number of days until due in there if you want. Now that's really it for the creation of the invoice. Nothing else do we need to bring in here. Because again, over here, what it's going to do is it's going to, under pending invoice items behavior, it's going to bring in any of the pending invoice items that have been created. And since we created an invoice item in the previous step, that's what's going to be included in the creation of this invoice. If you have any other pending invoice items out there for this client, they will also be included on this invoice. But if all you're doing is creating invoices through automation, you'll only ever have one invoice item each time. Now, lastly, this does not actually send the invoice. We have to create the next step here of finalizing a draft invoice. And all we have to do is pass along the invoice ID from the previous step. If we don't do this, then it never actually creates the finalized invoice. And this invoice will sit inside of our Stripe account in draft mode until we go in and approve it. So if you want that functionality, if you want to be going through your Stripe account and verifying these invoices are correct before sending them, then eliminate this step. You're all good. You've already done it. And then you can just go into Stripe and do it. If you want these invoices to be sent out based on your Stripe settings, well, then you need to finalize the invoice. Otherwise, it's going to stay forever in draft mode. And that's almost it. The last step for us is bringing that information back into SmartSuite. So in this step, we are again are finding our solution in SmartSuite, mapping to our table, and we're saying, hey, look, we want to update this particular record. We know what that record is, again, because we passed that record ID in the subject of the very first step in our automation. But all we need to do here is update our invoice ID from the step in our automation where we create the invoice. This is going to bring that Stripe ID back into SmartSuite, and that way we're able to store the Stripe invoice information, and we can do more fun stuff with it in the future. As I mentioned, if it gets paid, we can update that status of the invoice. If we want to void it, maybe what we do is we have a button we push in SmartSuite that says void this invoice, and it's going to use that ID that lives in SmartSuite to do all of that. Any additional automation that we ever want to do to this invoice, it has to know the invoice ID, because that is how Stripe thinks about this particular object. So that's it. Those are all the components. Let's test this out. Be sure to save your automation. Be sure to turn your automation on. And for us, I've got some stuff in the queue already that I will delete, and we will go ahead and run this once just ourselves to watch it. Once I have a record that meets my conditions, as I do here, it's gonna automatically send information to that. So I'm going to back out, I'm gonna pull my contact, and I'm gonna remap my contact. That's going to send the Mailhook the information it needs, and this automation is gonna start running. And so over here, we can see, hopefully, that that starts running in just a moment. There it goes, boom, 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 we're almost done. There we go. Let's now pop back into SmartSuite. Here we see the invoice ID that was updated, and I can flip into Stripe and find the information I'm looking for. So here I am in Stripe, now looking at this invoice. You'll see that it's already been finalized. It is an open invoice, not a draft. This is something that would have been sent to john@acmetest.com. Sorry, whoever has that email address. It was meant as an example. But here is a live payment page that we can go take a look at. And this is what John would get in this example. He's going to get our actual invoice from Stripe. He can go and look at the invoice here, download it to his system. He can pay with a card or a US bank account. He can go and take a look at the invoice. Here is the example service at $1,000. All the different components that we put together. This is a live invoice ready for John's payment, all from just setting up some data inside of SmartSuite. Pretty cool stuff. I know we went really fast in this video, so hopefully you were able to get a lot of value from it, but if you have any questions, anything I skipped or you missed, just drop them below and we'll do our best to answer. And in the meantime, keep on building.